silver on the lower cheeks. And I also put in some of the missing silver that was on top. They break it up into bright silver, and then there's like a light silver and a dark silver. And what they've got you doing is like for instance here, there was like a teeny bit of bright silver, but then the rest is the other silvers. And they should have just done it one silver and you could have weathered it on top. But anyway, so there's a lot more silver showing. And I know it doesn't make sense right now because all the other colors are missing. And I know this green is wrong, but it's gonna get fixed. So what I started to do was, my plan was, I was gonna start topically putting in the other colors. And then I realized that's stupid because that's gonna be like a final layer anyway. So I'm just gonna, I just put in all the missing stuff. There's something here I call the dragon. That looks like a dragon. And there was one there and a bunch here. And what else did I add? This one is a big one. So tomorrow I will mask the silver and spray the green here. So both of these greens will match. So at that point, then I can remask all the silver and then try to fix the green. Once the green's fixed, I can topically do everything else. So that's the plan. Mask, green, mask, fix green, and topically go on. But of course I gotta do all that other stuff too. Mask the silver and spray the green. So right now this green matches this and this. I'm gonna leave on the stencil, masking, and I'm going to do an overspray of this XF65 to try to darken. I'm just gonna try it down here first, just to try to darken this up, dirty it up a bit, because I believe that the base color should be a darker green. And if it's good, I'm gonna go ahead and remask the silver up here and then spray the top again.
Hey guys, so yesterday, Diane, who was Sue's sister, Sue was Rick's girlfriend. They both passed in the last few years. Rick's who I got the armor from, thanks to Sue. But she came over with a box of Rick and Sue's things, and these are some of the things that were in there that she gave me. So this is a signed, it's actually a t-shirt holder signed by Jeremy Bullock. It's not been opened, so the t-shirt's still in there. I'm gonna leave it in there. I just think that's so cool. Also, this was signed. I think this is Jeremy as well. If it's not Jeremy, then it could be Daniel. So I have to check the signatures. Yeah, maybe it is Daniel. This was Rick's Shadowfax card. I think that's pretty cool. I never had this one actually, so pretty special. And this is really special. This is his founder's favorite medal for doing 10 troops, the Northeast Remnant. You can see this was awarded November of 2015. And just another little fet. So I'm very grateful for her to let me have these things. Very special. So yesterday I darkened up the bottom here. I don't know if you can get a really good sense of how different they are. They are different. This is greener and darker. And this is the XF65. Some people use this for their basic armor. You can see that it is definitely darker than the top. So I feel like this is a closer olive to the true color. This is just a bit too light, almost like the armor for ESB. So remember, I'm going Rotj. So today I'm gonna remask all of this silver damage and then repaint the top green and then decide where to go from there. Every day it looks a little bit more and more like a Rotj Boba Fett. Because I had a lot of stuff going on at school, but what I've done is remasked all the silver, and then I went ahead and made a dark gray and just sprayed the areas that I thought were dark gray, and then I made a light gray, sprayed some areas that I thought were light gray,
and then mask those. So on top of this dome right now, I've got areas of silver, dark gray, and light gray. I'm gonna let this masking dry, and then I'm gonna overspray the green again to get this green to match this green. And then once that's done, I can topically start to do everything else except for the orange stripes, which I will airbrush. So I know I said I was gonna do all of the damage topically, but I am trying to airbrush some of it. So I have darkened up the green, and I've got a little bit of light and a little bit of dark on the dome as well. You can see there's some areas of light and dark. Now obviously this is also gonna get more of the other colors, since there's still a lot more colors to come. And then also a gray wash to smoke it up. Because right now it's just a little bit too DOD army green, and you know, by putting the gray wash over it, it kind of lightens up, just kind of like how I did on the jetpack. But overall, I'm happier with this green than the green that I had before. It was too light. It was almost, I don't even know how to describe it, like just the wrong green, kind of like green like that wall, just too bright. You can see the difference.